Did we need to open the playbook against BC? Clearly
not. I don't
think
anybody's asking to open the playbook. Just I think situationally there were some things that they did that were kind of head scratching. Some of it was there were some play calls that were really good and they just weren't mm-hmm. executing. And some it was like, why would you call that? I don't think anybody's asking Clemson to open the playbook and just put everything that you have on film. I think there were some things situationally.
There was some questionable, like you say, situational calls that I don't think should have been made. But I hope we start off better next game. So do I. Hope we start off faster.
We'll need to,
especially on offense.
Florida State's a little bit more capable, and I mean they've got injuries as well, but they are in a much much better shape than BC is.
I really wish we'd just come out and dominate hard so we can get Cade some playing time in the second half. What if DJ gets hurt, God forbid? Well, if DJ gets hurt, we're probably in some trouble. I don't know if Cade's ready. We're not at practice. We don't know how he looks in practice. It would be nice to be getting some blowouts and be able to get the depth some work, some significant snaps. But honestly, it just hasn't been in the cards, especially these, Wake Forest game and the North Carolina State game. We knew that wasn't going to happen. Trust in Dabo. It's clear the reason we won two titles. Look what his assistants are doing.
I mean, no one's saying that we don't. DKT, yeah, he's kind of going off in the chat right now. Nobody's saying that we don't trust Dabo or anything. There's room for criticism. It's not this team did not play particularly well. They did not play up to what we know they can play. I mean, we know how talented the guys on this roster are.
Yeah.
And there were things that they didn't do tonight that if you want to be where if you want to be in the playoff, if you want to be able to compete for a national championship, you got to do those things better. We don't trust Dabo or anything like that. And, there's room for criticism.
Yeah.
It's constructive. We're not putting down anybody or saying, this player sucks or anything like that.
Absolutely not.
It is what it is. There's things that can be done that are better.
I mean, our goal is playoffs and beyond, right? That's typically, Clemson's preseason goals, at least on a fan side of it, I think. And we're talking about, getting better for that when that time comes. I think we're doing just fine. We'll keep winning ACC games, even if we keep playing like that. But that's not the end goal. Let's see what else we got here. Some Streeter hate in the chat. You see this? Some people saying Streeter's fun. Some people saying Streeter's not.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm not on the. I'm not a Streeter here.
I'm not hating on Streeter either. I think we've already said that we didn't like some of the calls tonight. But by no means does that mean I'm out on Coach Streeter. I think he's done.
I think he's done fine. Yeah, when it was Jeff Scott and Tony Elliott, there were plenty of.
Plenty of games
where you were like, well, okay, what are we doing here?
Right.
And then there were games where they looked good and you saw, it's like, okay, well, when they get in their rhythm and they get in their bag, as far as play calling is concerned, they look really good. And
the same guy
calling any different.
Yeah. The same guy calling plays tonight was the same guy calling plays against North Carolina State and Wake Forest too.
Yeah.
So, we'll be okay. It wasn't a great game. That's all we're saying. It wasn't a great game. No need to hit the red panic button. No need to, talk about any sort of, coach not getting his job done because it's way too early on both of them. And I don't think they've done anything to warrant
right
that kind of sentiment from any fans, really. Hunter gets in, says, we're not going to win another title with his play calling. Well,
we don't know that.
We'll see. We'll see. Stop worrying about demonstrating
dominating,
excuse me, weaker opponents and looking good. No one in the ACC is beating Clemson.
You might be right about that, but yeah. There's a school of thought that, you know, the sign of a really, really good team is, you know, beating the team soundly that you're supposed to beat soundly.
Right.
I don't think Clemson could, because I mean, Clemson won 10 games last year, but they won a lot of one possession games. Was that team was, you know, would you have said that, you know, last year, like say we didn't play Georgia, but the overall team was still the same, you know, and we're going into the NC State game knowing we just came off of a 14-8 win over Georgia Tech. Would you say, oh, no one's going to beat us? Cause it was, you know, that team wasn't bad by any objective means, but you know, just as far as the ability of the, you know, the talent level, you know, they should have played a lot better last year. And they didn't, yep, for a lot of reasons. Doing things that, you know, making it look easy against the teams that should look easy against is the sign of a good team.
Yeah.
And I thought in defensively, they did make it look easy for most.
Yeah, no.
They played really well.
I think we did enough tonight. It just wasn't, you know, there's room for improvement. That's it. Room for improvement.